I'm Dr. Frita. I'm a board-certified kidney and high blood pressure doctor, and today I'm giving you 9 mistakes you're making while measuring your blood pressure. Number 6 could be dangerous. According to the CDC, almost half of the adults in America have high blood pressure, yet only 1 out of every 4 has it under control. This is a problem because we know that high blood pressure or hypertension is a leading cause of heart disease, strokes, and according to the National Kidney Foundation, high blood pressure is the second leading cause of kidney failure. So it's important that we measure our blood pressure properly, right? Of course it is. Well, here's the issue. Not only do I find that sometimes my patients are making mistakes when measuring their blood pressure, but sometimes other healthcare providers are making mistakes. And this can lead to patients being undertreated for their high blood pressure, or it can mean that they're being overtreated and being given medicines unnecessarily just because the blood pressure is not being measured properly. So let's go ahead and nip this in the bud right now, because today I'm giving you 9 mistakes that you're making when measuring your blood pressure. And guess what? Other people might be making those same mistakes also. Keep watching. Be sure to download your copy of my book. It's called Under Pressure. It's your step-by-step guide on how to control high blood pressure. This book is packed with valuable tools, guidelines, and information to help you to control high blood pressure. Click the link in the description to get your copy today. Please go ahead and give this video a like and a share as we get started, because I'm about to give you some evidence-based medicine on how to measure your blood pressure properly. I can tell you from personal experience that there are many, many patients and assistants and others, doctor's offices, who take blood pressure the wrong way, and it can lead to dangerous complications. I'll give you an example of one of my patients. It was a female patient, and she was someone who was living with being obese, okay? She was living with obesity, and she had very large arms. Well, every time she took her blood pressure at home, it was extremely high, and she said that when she went to her other doctor's offices, the blood pressure was extremely high as well. So what would happen? She would keep getting more and more prescriptions for medications, which she would take because she was actually a pretty compliant patient. But she would also complain that she had a lot of dizziness, a lot of lightheadedness, a lot of low energy. And this is something she said that had been going on for a while. Well, when she came to our office and we measured her blood pressure, it was actually on the low side. That's because she had been making mistakes with measuring her blood pressure, and so had other healthcare providers. I'll tell you what that mistake was as we keep going in this video. So let's go ahead and dive in. Here are 9 mistakes you're making while measuring your blood pressure. Number 1, measuring at the wrong time of day. Yes, this can be an issue because your blood pressure might fluctuate depending on the time of day it is and what activities you have. So if you measure it after you've just eaten a big meal, or after you've exercised, or after you're stressed or been in road rage, or if you're a smoker, I advise you not to be a cigarette smoker, but if you take your blood pressure after you smoked a cigarette, that can alter it as well. And so it is recommended that you measure your blood pressure multiple times during the day, but at the same time each day for consistency. I recommend that my patients measure their blood pressure, for example, in the mornings before they eat breakfast, and in the evenings before they eat dinner. Please don't measure your blood pressure for at least a half hour after you have eaten, exercised, had an alcoholic beverage, after you've had caffeine, after you've smoked a cigarette. Give yourself some time to make sure that you're measuring your blood pressure at the right time each day. Number 2, using the wrong blood pressure cuff size. This is a huge one because if the blood pressure cuff is too small, it will give you a falsely high blood pressure reading. And if the blood pressure cuff is too big, it will give you a falsely low blood pressure reading. Now, this is what happened in the patient example that I gave you at the beginning. She was a lady of a larger size and she had some thick arms, okay? Her arms were large. When you purchase blood pressure cuffs, they come with a default size, right? And if you don't know, you automatically use that size. Makes sense, right? Wrong. What I need for you to do is to look at the inside of the cup, and it will tell you the size of your arm that is appropriate for that cup. For example, it might say 9 to 12 inches. Okay, 9 to 12 inches where? What do they mean? What they're talking about is the circumference around your arm. And so if you think about your arm right here, kind of in the middle where the muscle belly is of your bicep, yeah. If you think about that part, get yourself a tape measure and measure around to see the circumference or the length that it takes to get around your arm. You can use a measuring tape, or you can also just get some yarn or a string, measure it, and then pull it out and put it next to a ruler to see the size of your arm. But that's what they mean when they're talking about either in inches or centimeters, your arm. So if your arm is larger than the range given that's written inside of that cuff, then you need a larger cuff. If your arm is smaller, then you need to get a smaller cuff. So what I have found over the years is that not only are patients making this mistake by using the wrong sized cuff, but a lot of times people in doctor's offices, the assistants in doctor's offices, are using cuffs that are the wrong size. And so it's important that you advocate for yourself. If you already know the size of your arm and that instead of the regular adult cuff or the large adult cuff, you might need the extra large cuff, or you might even have a really big arm and you might need the thigh cuff. But if you know that, then when the nurse or when the assistant goes to take your blood pressure at a doctor's office, please speak up for yourself and say, excuse me, I notice this cuff you're using looks a little bit small. I actually usually need a thigh cuff, or I usually need a very large adult cuff to get the proper measurement. Just go ahead and say that to make sure you're getting the right measurements. Also, if you have a very small arm, a lot of my patients, especially my older patients, patients with low appetites, or patients who have been on chemotherapy, who are very thin, who aren't eating much, a lot of times they will need a very small cuff, sometimes even cuffs the size that children will use. That's important because if they go into the office and if the cuff is too big for that patient, or at home, if you're using a blood pressure cuff that is too large for a patient, then you might think that your loved one has dangerously low blood pressure. You might try to rush them, send them to the ER, when honestly, you just need to have a smaller cuff. And so the proper cuff size is extremely important when it comes to measuring blood pressure. Again, for the patient I described at the beginning of this video, everyone, she and the people in other doctor's offices, were using blood pressure cuffs that were too small. Therefore, she was getting falsely elevated blood pressures, and they kept increasing the amount of blood pressure medications that she was on. The reason she was feeling fatigued and lightheaded was because she was being over-medicated and her true blood pressure was actually very low. When we use the proper cuff, in her case, it was a thigh cuff, okay, a pretty large cuff. When we used the proper cuff, we got her proper blood pressure. We were able to take her off some of those medications and to treat her properly. Please share this information because this is a common mistake. You must measure your blood pressure with the proper blood pressure cuff size. As I share this information, do you find that you have more questions? Do you want to talk to me about your personal medical issues or your personal high blood pressure? Well, if so, you are in luck because I offer a telehealth concierge service. We can book a time where you can talk to me for the entire time about your own personal history, and I will give you my professional medical advice one-on-one, and I can talk to you from anywhere in the world. If you're interested, please click the link in my description or visit drfrita.com. I'm telling you, it's a great service. Number three, trying to take your blood pressure over your clothing. This is a very common mistake. A lot of times people at home or at doctor's offices will just put the blood pressure cuff over their clothes, over their shirts, over their dresses, even over sweatshirts, and they do it out of convenience. The issue is that when there are clothing materials that are in between the blood pressure cuff and your skin, this can add to resistance. It can lead to a falsely elevated blood pressure or just inconsistent numbers. How to correct this mistake? Make sure that you're measuring your blood pressure over the bare skin on your arm. So make sure you wear short sleeves, or you roll up your sleeves, or if you have on a sweatshirt or a jacket, just slip it off so that the blood pressure cuff is directly on your skin. This gives you a much more accurate blood pressure reading. Question, have you been making any of these common mistakes? Which ones? Please comment down below. Number four, incorrect body and arm position. This is a huge one. And even when I'm a patient getting my blood pressure taken, I oftentimes have to remind the nurse's assistants, look, y'all are doing it wrong. I try not to be a know-it-all when I go to the doctor's office, but sometimes I'm a little bit of a know-it-all. So let me tell you this, so you can be a know-it-all also. It is important that your arms are in the right position. So whatever arm the blood pressure is being taken from must be at the level of the heart, okay? So it should be at a table or on a desk at the level of your heart. If your arm is dangling down, that can give you a falsely high blood pressure. If your arm, for some reason, is up high, that can give you a falsely low blood pressure, okay? So the arm should be at the level of the heart when you get your blood pressure measured. Also, your legs should be uncrossed, your feet should be flat on the ground, and you should be sitting in a chair with the back, and you should be sitting upright. If you have your legs crossed during your blood pressure readings, which happens very often, if the legs are crossed, that can give you a falsely high blood pressure, and this is how. When the legs are crossed, that acts like a tourniquet or like a band that is pushing blood into your upper body. So what will happen? The readings in your arms will be higher. There'll be a higher blood pressure. So make sure that your arm is at the level of your heart in order to correct this mistake and that your legs are uncrossed, feet flat on the ground. Trust me, you'll get better readings. Number five, texting, talking, moving, or other distractions while getting your blood pressure taken. Yes, this can be a problem at home, and it can be a problem if you go to an office. What happens is this, if you are moving about, if your mind is other places, if you're fidgeting, if you're distracted, if you're having conversation, then that can give you a falsely elevated blood pressure. How do you correct this mistake? Sit still and be quiet, please. It's not that hard. Okay, maybe it's hard, but you really have to do it for your health. What you should do is relax, just have slow, deep breaths, not only while you're getting your blood pressure taken, but for at least 5 minutes. You want to sit down and do not multitask, do not fidget. This will give you an accurate reading because the last thing you want to do is to be talking, texting, fidgeting, and then you go in and the doctor tries to give you medicines that you don't need when really, had you just taken a beat and been calm and quiet, you could have had a more accurate reading. And again, this is not only advice for when you're at home, but also for you to advocate for yourself. Because a lot of times when the nurse's assistants are taking your pressure, they're under pressure in order to get things done. And they'll be asking you all kinds of questions while they're taking your pressure. So you can politely ask them, please, I'd like to be quiet while I'm taking my pressure. Can you please retake it? Okay, you better advocate for yourself. No texting, no talking, no fidgeting while taking your blood pressure. That's a mistake. Number six, now this is a dangerous one. Only taking one reading and trusting it. Now, this is a problem because yes, we know that blood pressure can fluctuate throughout the day, but also from minute to minute, depending on your position, it might change. And so if you take just one measurement and that's it, and then you act on it, then it could lead to you being over-medicated or under-medicated. So it's important to take multiple readings. Here's how you remedy this mistake. Check your blood pressure multiple times, two or three times, and make sure you give it a minute or two in between each reading. If most of the readings are similar to each other, then the most common readings are probably accurate. If all of the readings are all over the place, check it in the other arm. And if you're still having issues, consult with your physician. At any rate, don't ever just take one random reading and make major changes. Check the blood pressure multiple times. Number seven, measuring blood pressure right after consuming caffeine, alcohol, or tobacco. Here's the issue. When you are drinking coffee with caffeine, a soda with caffeine, when you're having yourself some spirit, some alcohol, or when you are smoking a cigarette, all of these things can cause a temporary rise in blood pressure. How to remedy the situation, okay, how to correct this mistake. Make sure that you wait at least 30 minutes after consuming caffeine, alcohol, or smoking a cigarette before you check your blood pressure. And please stop smoking cigarettes altogether. They are on the risk factor list for just about everything. Heart disease, lung cancer, cervical cancer, kidney cancer, emphysema, COPD. Okay, this is your public service announcement. Stop smoking cigarettes. Question, what is the one change that you will make when taking your blood pressure at home after watching this video? Please comment down below. Number 8, taking your blood pressure with a full bladder. This is a common one because a lot of times patients will wake up in the morning with a full bladder. They'll check their blood pressure before they use the restroom, or patients will go to the doctor's office and they anticipate that they might have to do a urine sample. And so they make sure that they hold their urine, they get their blood pressure taken with a full bladder just in case the doctor asks for a urine sample. Well, this is a no-no because guess what? Having a full bladder can increase your blood pressure by as much as 10 to 15 points, by as much as 10 to 15 millimeters mercury. That's a big deal. So how to correct this mistake? Always empty your bladder before checking your blood pressure. Number 9, not remembering to keep a consistent log of your blood pressure readings. This is important. A lot of times we get caught up with our busy days and we'll take our blood pressure maybe only when we're stressed out, or maybe we'll only remember to take our blood pressure when we're actually taking our medicine and being compliant. Or we might actually double up on medicine because we know we haven't been compliant and you only take the blood pressure readings then. This is a no-no. It's important for your doctor to really see accurate blood pressure recordings throughout the days over several days. And that is the best way for you to be managed. So how do you correct this mistake? Make sure you give yourself a reminder. Have a dedicated notebook where you record your blood pressure readings, or a spreadsheet or an app. And actually set a little alarm to remind yourself to take your blood pressure at those consistent times each day and to write it down. To learn more about blood pressure, make sure you check out my many YouTube videos on blood pressure, including The Truth About High Blood Pressure and How to Lower Your Blood Pressure Naturally. If you found this information to be helpful and informative, please be sure to like this video and to share it with the people you care about. Also, if you have not done so already, please be sure to subscribe to my channel. Again, I am a board-certified kidney doctor and high blood pressure specialist, and so taking care of patients with high blood pressure is what I do day in and day out. I've just shared with you 9 of some common mistakes that people make while taking blood pressure, and I want you to share this information because it will not only help you when checking your blood pressure, but it will also help you and your loved ones to advocate for themselves when they go to their doctor's offices and when sometimes mistakes are being made there. Hey, everybody's human. I want you to take notes and really try to commit some of these common mistakes to memory so that you will do better. And as always, I thank you for your support, and I want you to do your best to live your healthiest, happiest life. I'm Dr. Frita.